Welcome graduates, welcome parents, our teachers, and all the guests who are present in the dais. Welcome to the curriculum culmination ceremony of the batch 2016-2020.
A small cheer and a great welcome makes a merry fest. Today's occasion is cheer-worthy indeed, as we, the STC family, is getting another chance to see you all under one roof again.
Although times are not favorable as we would like it to be, and this may not be the closure you have hoped for, but we are doing our absolute best to make this ceremony a grand success during these tough times.
This is not a closure, but the start of a new chapter as you move on with a souvenir of your college life to the outside world, where you shall find new opportunities.
So without any further delay, let's start the ceremony with the blessings of the Almighty Himself.
Let's welcome the college choir to the dais for the prayer. And we request everyone to stand up for the prayer.
Please occupy your seats. Now, we would like to invite a prominent personality of our STC family, our respected vice principal, and moreover, the leading man of computer science department himself, Professor Imtiaz MP, to deliver the welcome speech.
Respected secretary of the college, Engineer Josh Thomas sir, Principal Dr. Shajan Kuriako sir, Chief Guest of the Day Professor PJ Kurian sir, HODs of various departments, my colleagues and my dear buddy engineers, parents, good morning to all. It's a very happy moment for us. 2016-20 batch have completed their BTech course of study. Today is the most awaited day of any BTech graduates. So the primary goal of study is completed. Next is to complete your responsibilities towards family, society, and country in the future. In the beginning itself, I wish a bright future to one and all. See, every year we conduct this event in the month of August itself. Unfortunately, due to the present scenario, this year the event is delayed. Anyway, by God's grace, now the situation become somewhat all right. Then I come to my duty to welcome you all to the curriculum culmination ceremony of 1620 batch. First, I welcome our beloved secretary and backbone of STC and St. Thomas Educational Trust, Engineer Joseph Thomas sir, who is always support for all the development initiative in the institute and in the society. So we welcome you, sir, to the 2016-20 batch curriculum culmination ceremony. Next, I welcome our chief guest. It's a great pleasure for me to welcome chief guest and the personality, Professor P.J. Kurian sir. Sir is former union minister and was a member of the Lok Sabha for 6 consecutive years. And you know, former deputy chairman, Rajya Sabha. Such a noble personality as our chief guest today. We are especially thankful to him as when we approached him with the invitation and requested him to grace the function as a chief guest. The time itself, sir accepted our request and readily agreed for today's event. So on behalf of one and all present here and on behalf of the STC family, we welcome you, sir, the culmination ceremony of 2016-20 batch. Next, I welcome our principal and backbone of our St. Thomas Educational, St. Thomas College, and Dr. Shajan Kuriyako, sir, who is always supportive for the developmental initiative in the institute and provide us with constant guidance and motivation for this curriculum culmination ceremony and all the event in the college. See, we extend a warm welcome you, sir, for the culmination ceremony of 2016-20 batch. Next, I welcome our treasurer, Jacobs Thomas, sir, to this function. Also, convey our gratitude for all the facilities and financial support extended for this today's event. So we welcome you, sir, to this ceremony. Next, I welcome all the HODs, faculties, teaching and non-teaching staff to this function. Next, I welcome all the parents of the students to this function. Lastly, I welcome all our 2016-20 batch students to your function, that is curriculum culmination ceremony. So I welcome you all 2016-20 batch to this function. Once again, I wish you all for bright career and future. I extend a warm welcome to you all present here. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, for your warm words. Next, we would like to invite another very influential presence in our institution and also the Secretary of St. Thomas Educational Society, Engineer Joseph Thomas, to the dais for the presidential address.
Good morning. The most respected the principal of this college, Dr. Shajan Kuriyako, sir, today's chief guest, the former deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha, and an eminent professor, Professor Vijay Kurian, sir. My colleague in the trust, Jacob Thomas, the vice principal, Professor India Sir, all HODs in the dais, teaching faculty members, senior staff members, and today's star of the event, my dear students, who has passing out the badge 2016-2020, and their beloved parents. It was unfortunate that this event was been delayed, for which some of the students were not able to attend it. But anyway, the situation has slightly been better, and by the grace of the God, we were able to conduct this program. My dear students who were with us for the last 4 years in this campus, they were the life of this campus, and they were the star of this campus. I respect you students, because you've been here as this institution has completed your engineering studies and thankfully achieved the highest pass percentage, which is 96 above on the final year examinations. Congratulations, students, and it is a great effort for the principal, all the teaching faculty, and the non-teaching faculty, and each and everybody in the campus for having such a wonderful completion of the courses. Now, dear students and their parents, you have completed your education major activities, and you have now achieved a graduation, and today is our graduation ceremony. There are students who will continue their higher education, or there are students who is seeking employment or already had employed. This is a turning point in your life. Only my advice before residing into my table, chair. Now you are proceeding to a second pattern of your life. You have completed your education. Now you are being out as a responsible person to serve your country, serve your society, and finally, your family. The education time is now over. You are now reaching to a great responsibility in your life, and this will not succeed unless you start hard working. Now, when you are out of this society, you might reaching various areas. You are going to meet various cultures, and some of you will be going out of the country, and some of you will be serving in the country. But my dear students, wherever you are, wherever you have presented the Almighty God yourself, please take it as a challenge. Start growing yourself. Success will not come very easy. Success will come only with the hard work. As I said before, you are going into a different environment, a different culture. You have to adopt that culture. There are difficulties. First, you find it is difficult to adopt into the society. But if you are patient enough, if you are ready to achieve your goal, you can easily achieve this. You might be reaching different personnel. You might be going to meet different culture bosses. But as our previous president, Dr. Abdul Kalam, said, you should have a goal and you should dream towards the goal. If you have a goal, you should plan to achieve that goal. Then you have to work hard. Maybe you not succeed in the first phase. It may take repeated try. Like a scientist who cannot invent anything on a mountain. You have to experience, that's why we call it experience, time and again, so that you can reach to a success. So please, my dear students, on behalf of St. Thomas Education Society and on behalf of every faculty who teached you, we are with you and we pray for Almighty God that you all will succeed in your life. Now, one more thing I should say. Adoption is something which you always should think about it. When you go out to a job area, there might be different culture you have to see, different attitude people, and it might be quite different. I personally has been worked about 23 years in a multinational, especially in a different work culture than Indians. The most difficult or most work-oriented societies are Japanese, Koreans, and Chinese. Let's forget about Chinese because we had about a lot of humanitarian problems in the Chinese culture. So we might be meeting different people, different cultural people, and we should try to adopt it. Now, once you have started to adopt it, once you plan yourself, it is easy to adopt it. One simple example I like to say and finish it off, that during my first phase of my employment, I had an opportunity to be a part of a team who was working in UK. I has been there for about 15 years for completing a tender. I done my job and we were having 18 hours a day working for that job. Once the tender is finalized, I was called and told that we are completing today at 10 o'clock the project. You can wind it up. You can take rest for about 2-3 hours. And your flight is back at 2 o'clock in the morning. I was astonished. Tears was coming out of my eyes. Because this is the first time I was in Europe. I want to see Europe at least one day. And what they said is, no, we don't mix work and social visit together. These are two things. Now, even though I feel it bad, then I was rejoined. I was very happy when I was told after 2 years that you will be having a paid vacation by the company. You can enjoy for 30 days. The company will pay everything for you, for your family. So these are the culture difference because they don't mix cultures together. They don't mix work and leisure together. Now, I have been adopted to that company and I find no difficulty in working with that company for the last 23 years before I start come and establish my own activities back in India. I have been once selected as the best, the foreign staff in the company where we have 1,800 engineers working all the time. So always, please make sure that you adapt to the society wherever you are, and you have no way to regret it. You will be success on it. Dear students, once again, thank you. As a member and a secretary who has been here all the time with you, you were one of the nice batch of students in this college. We love these students. You were all with us. And even though it is only a 10-year-old college, during your time, you should be proud of it. We have achieved the ISO, the highest level in ISO. Also, we had NAC accreditation. And even during your period only, we have completed our MBA. And unfortunately, because of the COVID, we are waiting for the inspection, which is delayed. So you will be walking out from this institution at a later date, by end of March or April, to be a part of accredited college. NAC accredited and NBA accredited. NBA is one of the organization which is acceptable by, it is organized by Washington Accord. So once again, thank you. On behalf of St. Thomas Education Society, the management, and the faculty members, and all staffs gathered here, we wish you a prosperous career on your life. Whenever you find a sign, time in your career, please do not forget to visit the college. Keep in contact with us. And we love your presence and your words from yourself. By saying that, once again, wish you all the success. Bye. See you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. A light, a symbol, and a ray of hope. In light, we reside and we thrive, as a testament to unity and success. We now invite all the dignitaries on the dais to come forward for the lamp lighting ceremony. I request everyone to stand up.
I request everyone to occupy your seats. Next, we have the chief guest introductory, as we all are eager to know more about him. We invite Ms. Christina Reggi from SM in Civil Engineering Department for the same.
A very warm good morning to one and all. I heartily welcome our very honorable chief guest, Professor P.C. Kurian, who was the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Our distinguished principal, Dr. Shajan Kuriakos, our esteemed secretary, Engineer Joseph Thomas, our vice principal, Imtiaz MP, our head of the departments, our faculties, parents, our stars of the ceremony, the young graduates. Professor P.C. Kurian, who is an Indian politician, a social worker, and an educationist. On the behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, for the precious moment when our college is celebrating its curriculum ceremony for the batch 2016-20, it is such a privilege to have him on the stage as a chief guest. Professor Pallad Joseph Kurian, who is from Tiruvalla, Pathanamthitta. He did his higher education from St. Thomas College, Koyanjeri, and had completed his graduation from Government Science College, Rewa, Madhya Pradesh. He had also held a recognized position as a professor at St. Thomas College, Koyanjeri. Professor P.C. Kurian was an esteemed leader of the Indian National Congress Party. He is also served as a Union Minister and a ward member of the Lok Sabha for 6 consecutive years for 1918 to 1999. He was also chairman in Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. Professor P.C. Kurian is always in front when it comes to helping the poor and the needy. Professor Kurian is an inspiration to many. We are proved to have a chief guest like him who is doing something in favor of the society. Such a selfless service is hard to witness. We are grateful to Professor P.C. Kurian for accepting our invitation and marking his presence here. Thank you.
Thank you, Christina. Now, we wholeheartedly invite the most eminent personality of today's ceremony, Professor P.J. Kurian, former Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha, for the inaugural address.
Engineer Sri Jose Thomas, Secretary of SES, Principal Dr. Shahjahan Shahjan Kuriakos, Vice Principal Professor Imtiaz MP, Engineer Professor Jerin Joy Varghese, other dignitaries on the dais, dear students, teachers, especially outgoing students, and friends. Now, first, see, the moment I reached this college, I found very good atmosphere, very good ambience, good building. I talked to the manager, Jose Thomas, and principal, good college, good facilities, good infrastructure. And before I reached here, I never knew that this is such a well-established college with a lot of infrastructure, good staff, and a reputed college. I am coming here for the first time, so I couldn't know more about the college. But now I congratulate, having understood that within the first 10 years of its establishment, it has become a NAC accredited college. Congratulations. It is again an ISO standardized college. Congratulations. And it is no doubt one of the reputed colleges in Kerala. I wish the college will further grow. Now you have 5 B.Tech courses and you are going to have M.Tech course and you are going to have new course, I think, on artificial intelligence, very, very, very important and relevant course, artificial nowadays. In the future, it is going to be the real source of income for the students. Therefore, I wish all the best to this college. Also, I wish all the best to the students, outgoing students, passing out with the B.Tech degrees. I know that you are going to the outside world with a lot of aspirations, ambitions. Most of you want to get a job. And yes, is it the only purpose of education, getting a job? That is the question I want to ask you. Lot of students study for getting a job, some job with lucrative salary. Likewise, lot of management start colleges. What is the aim? Thinking that there will be some profit, profit motive. Profit motive colleges and students with the only motive of getting job. Both are equally dangerous. I understood that this is a different college, not profit motive. They have understood the meaning of education. And that is why this college is surviving, even though many of the self-financing colleges in state, they are being closed. I asked Sri Joseph Thomas how many colleges are already closed in Kerala. Quite a few number. But this college survives, grows, because the intention of the management is not profit making, but running a well planned, well aimed educational institution to provide students the best possible training and also to imbibe on them the national responsibility they have to bear. My dear students, that is the most important thing. Are you just here for getting a job only? I would say no. I will tell you a small story. There were three workers breaking the stones for a building, for a college building. Three workers breaking the stones, cutting the stones to pieces in order to construct a building for an education institution. The first employee was asked, "What are you doing?" He replied, "I am cutting the stone." The second was asked, "What are you doing?" He replied, "I am cutting the stone for building a school, building a college." The third one said, "I am cutting the stone and thereby becoming part of the nation building activity, the nation building activity." All the three were doing similar, the same job. But see the difference in intention. One is saying that I am cutting the stone to maintain my family. Second is saying I am cutting the stone for building a college. The third is saying that I am, thank you. The third is saying that I am getting involved in the nation building activities. So, what are you going to do? Are you going for getting a job? Or are you going to do something for the sake of your family only? Or are you going to get involved in the nation building activities? Remember, you are given the training to go outside and serve the society and be part of the nation building activity. To serve the society and to be part of the nation building activity. That is the first thing you should have in mind, is the commitment to the society. A BTech degree is not enough. More than that, you should have a commitment to the society. And you should know wherever you are going to be, whether you are in a company, whether you are in a college, whether you are in any other field, you should know you are part of the nation building activity, and you are part of this great task of nation building. That is what you are for. Remember, I'll tell you, I was the chairman of the most prestigious university in India, IIT Delhi, Indian Institute of Delhi. I was its chairman for 5 years. Then we called the students and we had an interview with the students. We asked the students, what is your aim? What is your aim? 50% of the students told they want to go abroad. Then we asked, why you want to go abroad? Half of them said, if you go abroad, you will get better salary, better emoluments. In India, it is not available. So 50% of students not bothered about the country. They are bothered about only their own perks and emoluments. They want a better living. If it is not available in India, it is better available in other countries, so they are going abroad. I was disappointed. I would say, yes, you can go abroad. You go abroad also for the nation, for the country. So this should be your motive, yes, to be part of the nation building with a commitment to the society. My second advice to you is, I don't call it advice or suggestion to you, is that you see, in our country, in our state also, education is prospering. Kerala is the most literate society. Lot of educational institutions, lot of engineering colleges, lot of science colleges. But unfortunately, something is lacking. What is that something lacking? I would say scientific outlook. Superstition is on the increase. In spite of the fact that many of the students are studying science, lot of science graduates, lot of postgraduates, but in this country and in the state, superstitious belief on the increase. Likewise, religious faith. You can see lot of people going to churches, lot of people going to temples, Sabarimala, because of restriction, because of COVID restriction, only 5,000 per day can go. Otherwise, there will be lakhs of people per day. In spite of all this, social evils are on the increase. Compared to a decade or a few decades, social evils in the state of Kerala is on the increase. You read the newspaper daily. So two contradiction, paradoxes I am saying. Number one, science study increases, but superstition increases. Number two, visitors, people to the church, to the temples, all increase, but social evils increase. It is a contradiction. It is for the youngsters to think about this. Why? Why this society is like this? You are going to a society, you are going outside the college, into a society where the superstition is increasing, where the social evil evils are on the increase. This is a problem the young, the youth have to confront with, not older people. For the older people, their innings are over or going to be over. It is for you to confront. A problem you have to confront. These two problems I am facing before you. Thirdly, I want to give you a small talisman, advice, which Mahatma Gandhiji has said. You are going out of this institution with B.Tech degree. Some of you will be going for higher studies. Some of you will be getting employed. But Gandhiji has said to everyone, whether in administration, whether in any other job, for all of us, Gandhiji has given an advice. Very simple. When you are dealing with a problem, you think about the poorest of the poor in the society and see if your decision is in his favor, then you proceed. That is, on all issues which come before you, some of you may be officers, some of you may be managers, some of you may can enter politics. Nowadays, politics is, there is no bar for scientists or engineers. In those times, usually advocates used to be in politics. Today, all, irrespective of their profession, can enter politics, can become anything. I myself was a science teacher. I was teaching physics in St. Thomas College, Kozhancheri. Just from there, I entered politics and became a member of parliament, then minister, then deputy chairman. And as I told you, once I was chairman of the Delhi IIT, the most prestigious university, all this. So therefore, you engineers can also become anything. Nobody can predict what you are going to be. You may be politician, you may be MP, minister, administrator, manager, anything, because the future is in front of you. And anyone who works can attain any of this position. Whatever position you are, my advice is, when you take a decision, remember the poorest of the poor. Your decision should be in favor of the poor. This is the talisman Gandhiji has given. That is the third point I want to tell you. I don't want to take more of your time. I think I have already spoken more than what I wanted. I thank all the students, the graduating students, then those who are already graduated and going out, the other students and teachers, for giving me a patient hearing. I thank the college, Sri Jose Thomas, the secretary of SES, Dr. Shajan Kuriakos, the principal, the vice principal, staff and others, for giving me a good reception and also inviting me to this grand institution. I am very much impressed by the way this college is being run by the management and also by the way the students are behaving. My best wishes to all of you, and I wish all the outgoing students all the best in life. Try, work, because if you work, God has given us two hands to work. You work and achieve your goal. You can dream. Our former president Abdul Kalam Azad has said, APJ Abdul Kalam has said, dream and try to achieve your dream. You can also dream and work for achieving your dream. Let finally you all reach your dream. You all see your dream become true. With these words, I wish you all the best. Thank you very much. And I inaugurate this passing out ceremony. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir, for your impactful words. I'm sure everyone present here are moved by them.
Next, we have certificate distribution for all our prodigies. And I request Professor P.J. Kurian to come forward for distributing the certificates. First is Civil Engineering Department, and I invite Professor Harindranath S., Head of Civil Engineering Department, to call the names of the graduates.
Very good morning to everyone. So it's my pleasure to call upon my dear final year students, 2020 pass out civil engineering students. First, Abhirami S. Kumar, Abhijit Krishnan, Anandu V. Ashogan, Anandas, Anandu R. Krishna, Ananda Parmanabhan, Anshu Vishwanath, Anshulj, Aradhyas, Arunas Vargis, Arya Surendran, Ashik Ali, Christina Stephen, Deepthi S, Ijaz Mohammed, Grishma V, Harikrishnan K, Jayesh Kumar T, Jeffin C. Wilson, Jizin K. M., Kartika S., Christina Stephen, Kiran Stephen, Libin Alex, Leah Elsa Jacob, Nisha Molam, Pavishankar, Pradeen, Pravida, Renu Rajan, Sajana S, Sanju Vargis, Sharadipan Roy, Shepiness John, Sneha Mohan, Sri Lakshmi S, Shruti Sri Kumar, Sudhish Shyam, Shyam S, Tony M. Thomas, Abhijit Roy, Tombi Daniel, Aishwarya Lakshmi, Jeffin John, Neha Prakash, Rohit John, Anjali Jain, Amelis. Krishna Chandran. Shamna is Subin Sudhakaran. So thank you.
Good afternoon. Now I will call mechanical engineering graduates. As I call the names, please do come and collect the certificates. Abhijit OL, Adarsh, Ajin Matthew Philip, Akhil M, Akhil Prasad, Akhil Pradaban, Anandu R, Aromal S, Bimit Vargis, Bipin Biju, Gokul Mohan, Gokul Nath, Gopi Krishna, Jaren P. Epen, Jitin Raj Johnson, as you come and collect the certificate, please make sure that you are wearing the mask. Jobin Jose, Manu Rajashekaran, Robin Reggie Thomas, Roshan Revi, Sachu Joseph, Siju George Viju, Subit Sam, Vishnu R, Alan Joseph, Anandu R. Pillai, Ashin E. George, Ashit Prasad, Davis John Thomas, Prashil Panikar R, Ronnie Koshi, and Sharath S. Thank you.
Good morning. I will call upon 2016 20 batch students. They can come forward, please. And number one, Abhijit S. Abhijit S. Then two, Bijin Binu. Buhari Shahjahan. Jensen D. Matthew. Jomon Jos. Rajasena. Robin George. Timin Thomas. And finally, Parvati R.
I invite Joe sir to come forward to distribute the certificates.
Good morning, one and all. Next, I would like to call upon Electronics and Communication Engineering graduates. First one, Adarsh S. Nair. Adarsh S. Nair. Next, Ivan Saji Abraham. Kartika S. Panikar. Pavitra P. And Ashlyn Thomas. Thank you.
CSE 2016-20 pass out students. First, Anjali Aravind, Atulya S.A., Krissa Susan Luke, Gladsey Rajan. Jay Shankar, Gina M. Roy, Gina Thomas, Joel M. John, Julie Elizabeth. Malu M. Nimra Sumaya Mahmood. Noel Philip. Parvati Venu. Pillai Vinayak Achay. Sheena Thomas. Shivapriya. Subin Alexander. Tindu Mariam Paul, Vrinda Vichayan, Atul Prasad, Bexi Anna Prasad, Chidin Jacob, Kevin Shaj. Linda Joseph, Nidinia Rachel Matthew, Renchita Revi, Reshma Reji, Roshni Philip. S. Amrita, Sarah Joseph, Sarah Susan John, Sharath H., Steve D. James, and Subin Sabu Samuel. Slowly. Thank you all.
Now we have award distribution to all the respective department toppers, and for that we request Professor P.J. Kurian sir once again for handing out the awards.
First is Civil Engineering Department, and the names are Renu Rajan, Abhirami S. Kumar,
next is Mechanical Engineering Department, Jijo Joseph, and I request Staff Advisor of Jijo Joseph to collect the award. Jerin P. Epen. Next is Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department, Parvati R. Rajasenan S. From Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, Karthika S. Panikkar. Ivan Saji Abraham. Next, from Computer Science Engineering Department, S. Amrita. Phoebe Elsa Aji, and I request Shamrat sir to collect the award.
Thank you all. Please have your seats. Next is the oath taking ceremony. And every graduate present here is provided with a file containing the oath. I request everyone to please stand up and take the oath in your hands. Please raise your right hands forward. And I request everyone to follow Dr. Shajan Kuryakko sir, who is going to voice the oath. Sir, please come forward to voice the oath.
So please repeat after me. As a professional engineer, I solemnly pledge to dedicate my service to the development of the society without any personal motive. Act with prime regard to public safety and interests. Practice my profession with conscience and dignity. Uphold the standing and reputation of the profession. Comply with the laws and regulations. Strive for the efficient and economic use of natural resources. Minimize the impact of engineering works on the environment and constantly strive to upgrade my skills and knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, and I request everyone to occupy your seats. Leaving behind a legacy only to be taken by the ones who follow, a limelight shall be passed down to keep it alive. And now we invite the representatives of 2016-20 batch from all the respective departments to pass on the light to all the 2017-21 batch representatives.
We, the batch of 2016-20, used our skills and knowledge for good, contributing to and living up to the ethical standards of the profession. With this pledge, we humbly request our fellow juniors to uphold the privilege of our college and use your skills and knowledge in upbringing the institution to a merit level. So, at this time, we are passing the light of knowledge and wisdom to our juniors.
We, the batch of 2017-21, is accepting the light of knowledge and wisdom and assure that we will abide by the rules and policies of the college and live up to its mission and vision. Thank you.
Next is award distribution to all the state level competition winners. I request our principal, Dr. Shajan Kuryakko sir, to come forward to distribute the awards. First, we have the ED Conclave 2020 second prize winners. As I call your names, please come forward to the stage. Mr. Jidin Jacob Isaac, Ms. Nidina Rachel Matthew, Ms. Reshma Reggie, Ms. Renjida Revi. These are the winners of the ED Conclave 2020 organized by the District Industries and Commerce Government of Kerala, which happened on the 29th and 30th of January of January 2020. Next is a distribution of Certificate of Appreciation, which is awarded to the Department of Civil Engineering for their outstanding contribution for the consultancy service offered in DPR preparation for the flood-affected roads in Alappuzha district as a part of the Rebuild Kerala initiative. And for this, I call upon their representative, Mr. Anandu R. Krishnan. And their HOD, please come on to the stage. I also invite Joe sir to come forward to present the memento.
Thank you, sir. Now we invite the backbone of our institution, the leading man of STCET himself, our most respected and much beloved principal, Dr. Shajan Kuriakos, to address all the graduates.
President of the meeting, Engineer Josh Thomas, sir. Chief guest of the day, Professor P.J. Kurian, sir. Sri Jacob Thomas, treasurer of this association, vice principal, heads of departments, colleagues, parents, and my dear budding engineers and my dear students. St. Thomas family feels proud as one more batch of BTech students are passing out today. Dear students, you are the first batch who have successfully crossed the hurdles of COVID-19 pandemic. You will be remembered in the future with the same tag. We are aware that we could not make your final year a fruitful as you dreamed. But I am sure that you had many other occasions like your final year tour and all. Your placement drives are still pending. We are aware that, and still we are trying to come up with a different solve those problems in different ways. And I take this opportunity to congratulate you and for your highest success rate in the final year examination. It was 95.6%. Congratulations to all the students. And my dear students, we have started implementing many of your suggestions which you have shared to me. A full-time placement officer is already appointed and a four-year training curriculum is finalized. So the training programs will start from the first year onwards and it will go till the end of the curriculum or the fourth year. Training curriculum is finalized and even today a parallel training session for the final year students are going on. Another change is introducing more curricular, co-curricular and extracurricular activities in the campus, that too fully designed and implemented by the students themselves. Our aim is to convert this campus into fully studently friendly campus. This was the promise which we have given to the students, including you. As a first step, Wednesdays will be uniform free day and students will be permitted to wear colored dress on that day, even though it will be with strict dress codes. We have also decided to increase the role of NSS in the campus. The social responsibility of the students must be improved, rather increased. this campus will be a garbage free campus hereafter. And formation of a student charity fund is also designed, and it is in the implementation stage. It will be fully handled by the NSS faculty and student volunteers. Dear students, our campus is highly panoramic. To enjoy the scenic beauty of the campus, especially we have a very beautiful lake in front of us, garden chairs and benches will be fixed at different locations of the campus with the recommendations or suggestions taken from the students also. We are planning, as a part of the co-curricular activity, we are planning to organize international conferences during the month of April. My dear students, our NBA visit, National Board of Accreditation at Jaipur, as mentioned rightly, it is planned in the month of March. We are given the date for the month of March. And by acquiring NBA accreditation, we will climb to a rare group of institutions where all the three certifications, that means NBA and NAC accreditations, at the same time, this ISO certifications will be there. So very rare group of institutions will join to that group in a short while from now. And students, our alumni association is fully recharged now. All the outgoing students are welcome and invited to join or to be a part of the alumni association. And my dear students, I wish you all a highly blooming years ahead, and also wish a well-settled professional and family life. And I also request to uphold the traditions and the moral values which you have acquired from this institution. And also request to stick on the words which you have recited just now during your oath ceremony, oath taking ceremony. I congratulate Professor Jerin and all heads of the committee members who have worked hard for the grand success of this program, that is curriculum culmination ceremony. Wish you once again all the best for your future. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir, for your inspirational words. Now, we have two of our graduates sharing their beloved experience and valuable remarks about our institution. First, I invite Mr. Ivan Saji Abraham from Electronics and Communication Engineering Department.
A very fine good afternoon to one and all gathered over here. Respected guests on the dais, teachers, parents, and all my dear friends. ഇപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങളുടെ മുന്നിൽ ഇങ്ങനെ നിൽക്കുമ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് ഓർമ്മ വരുന്നത് ഞാൻ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഈ കോളേജിലേക്ക് കാലെടുത്ത് വെക്കുമ്പോഴാണ്. ഞാനിവിടെ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് വരുമ്പം എൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ പ്ലസ് ടുവിൻ്റെ ഒരു ജസ്റ്റ് പാസ് മാർക്ക് ലിസ്റ്റും കൊണ്ടാണ് ഞാൻ ഇവിടെ ഇവിടെ വരുന്നത്. പക്ഷേ ഇന്ന് ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് പഠിച്ചിറങ്ങുമ്പോൾ അത്യാവശ്യം നല്ലൊരു മാർക്ക്, നല്ലൊരു പെർസെൻറ്റേജോടെ തന്നെ കുറേ നല്ല ഓർമ്മകളോടെയാണ് ഞാൻ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് പഠിച്ചിറങ്ങുന്നത്. ലൈക്ക് എൻ്റെ കരിയറിലുണ്ടായ റൈസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നതിൻ്റെ പിന്നിൽ അതിൻ്റെ ഒരു നല്ല റോള് വഹിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത് എൻ്റെ ടീച്ചേഴ്സാണ്. അവരുടെ സപ്പോർട്ടും ഗൈഡൻസും ഇല്ലായിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ ഞാൻ ഒരുപക്ഷെ ഇങ്ങനെ നിൽക്കില്ല, ലൈക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു അവാർഡ് മേടിക്കില്ല. സോ എനിക്ക് എൻ്റെ ഹൃദയത്തിൻ്റെ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്ന് അവരോടൊരു നന്ദി പറയണമെന്നുണ്ട്. പിന്നെ ഇവിടേക്ക് വന്നപ്പോൾ എന്നെ വെൽക്കം ചെയ്ത എല്ലാ നോൺ ടീച്ചിങ് സ്റ്റാഫും മാനേജ്മെൻറ്റും, ലൈക്ക് ഒരു സെക്കൻഡ് ഹോം ഫീലിംഗ് ആണ് എനിക്കിവിടെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നത്. സോ എനിക്ക് എനിക്ക് പറയാൻ വാക്കുകൾ കിട്ടുന്നില്ല. സോ എനിക്ക് എൻ്റെ ജൂനിയേഴ്സിനോട് പറയാൻ ഒറ്റ കാര്യം മാത്രമേ ബാക്കിയുള്ളൂ. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വേണ്ടതെല്ലാം ഈ ക്യാമ്പസിൽ തന്നെയുണ്ട്. അത് നിങ്ങൾ തന്നെ അന്വേഷിച്ച് കണ്ടുപിടിച്ച് എടുക്കണം. സോ താങ്ക് യു. ഐ വിഷ് എവരി വൺ എ ബ്രൈറ്റ് ഫ്യൂച്ചർ അഹെഡ്.
താങ്ക് യു ഐവൻ ഫോർ യുവർ വാല്യുബിൾ വേർഡ്സ് ആൻഡ് വി വിഷ് യു ഓൾ സക്സസ് ഫോർ ഇൻ യുവർ ഫ്യൂച്ചർ. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഐ ഇൻവൈറ്റ് മിസ് എസ് അമൃത ഫ്രം കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ സയൻസ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെൻറ്റ്.
very warm good afternoon to one and all present here, honorable guests, dear parents, teachers and my fellow graduates. I am so honored to get this opportunity to stand in front of you two and say a few words today. First of all, from the entire batch of computer science 2016 to 20th batch, I thank the college management for arranging this graduation day ceremony for all of us amidst the COVID-19 situations. Today was the day all of us dreamed about. I was even undecided of today as a while, especially considering all the changes the last few months have taught us. There was a time when I was even unsure about day even I am around here to be unsure of day I am here present here. So when I first came to St. Thomas College of Engineering as a migrated student from Carmel Engineering College, never did I think that I would be standing up here in front of you to say that St. Thomas had changed my life for better. I can honestly say that all the teachers, especially our HOD, Imtiaza, who had supported us in overcoming everything, and he was a father figure for all of us. I owe a big thank you to all the teachers who had supported us in our studies, all the lab faculties and office faculties who had helped in one or the other way. I also thank my family who for their never-ending support and belief in me. I am so grateful for having them in my life. Above all, every single graduate who are sitting in front of me today, who had worked so hard in reaching up to here, I thank all for your hard work. I'm concluding my words by saying that wherever you go, wherever you get far in your life, you will be not based on what you already know. You will be based on what you are going to learn while you are leaving this college. So be bold, be happy, and remember the values that St. Thomas had taught us. Thank you all for listening to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Amrita, for your valuable words and all the best in your future ventures.
Now we invite Engineer Jose Thomas sir to present Professor P.J. Kurian with a token of our gratitude. Next, we invite another very influential personality of our institution, the head of Mechanical Engineering Department, Mr. Jerin Joy Varghese, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Respected dignitaries on and off the dais, a very good afternoon one and all. My duty is to extend a hearty thanks to all who are assembled over here. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Almighty God for all the immense blessings. Next, I would like to thank our Honorable Chief Guest, Professor P.J. Kurian, sir. Despite being very busy, he accepted our invitation and he came here and gave us a wonderful speech, and that was truly inspirational. So, on behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, I thank you with all my heart. Now, I would like to thank our Secretary, Engineer Jose Thomas, sir, who is a vital advisor in all our activities. Sir, I thank you. Now I take this opportunity to thank our treasurer, Mr. Jacob Thomas, sir, who is our financial advisor in all activities. Sir, on behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, I thank you, sir. Now I take this opportunity to thank our beloved principal, Dr. Shajan Kuriakos, a vibrant personality and the man behind this event. Sir, on behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, I thank you, sir. Now, it's my turn to thank our Vice Principal, Professor Imtiaz MP, who has been the backbone of every academic activity. Sir, on behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, I thank you. Now, it's my turn to thank all the chief invitees. It's none other than the 2016-20 batch. I'm so moved, what should I say, because this is something, a great time right now, because I'll always cherish the memories I have been with you guys. Do keep in touch with us, and once again, thank you for coming here
Thank you. Now it's my turn to thank the final year guys who really was with us and really made your time to coordinate all the events. You guys were awesome. Thank you. And on behalf of St. Thomas College of Engineering and Technology, we thank you. Last but not least, I should thank all the HODs and office staffs and all the faculty members who really put in the maximum effort to make this event so beautiful. Once again, thank you from my heart. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Now we invite the college choir for the national anthem.
All the graduates are requested to stay inside the auditorium. Thank you all for your cooperation and making this event a grand success.